I'm here with Leslie DeBola, and let me refill my martini here. Would you like some?
Oh, certainly. Thank you, Captain.
There you are. Happy Cheers. Halloween.
Happy Halloween. It's great to be here.
It's great to see you.
Thank you.
It's always fun to have you come by and bring us stuff.
Exactly.
And you have a Halloween theme. Right?
You can mask your pain, or you can take care of it and adapt to it.
There you go.
There we go.
And the traditional ice bag.
This is so simple. I always say we have high tech and we have low
right.
tech. Well, this is about as low tech as you get, but it is so effective. You can take it literally, absolutely anywhere. Stick in a purse, in a bag. It's actually, this is like pleated, so it gets bigger.
Yeah.
Throw ice in here, throw a tiny bit of water, and you've got a really nice cold pack that you can put anywhere. And then since it squishes, it stays where you put it.
It's amazing. They've been around for 100 years or whatever, and they still...
And it does hold vodka.
It does. It does hold vodka. All right.
And then... we have the traditional hot and cold packs.
Mm-hmm.
We have some that have straps, and the straps are all flexible, so they fit various sizes and body parts and all that. This one's a hot and a cold. Some of them are hot, some of them are cold only.
It can do both.
Yeah, but this one does both, and these are really nice because they're filled with beans. And so it's actually a moist heat. What the beads do is they take the moisture from the environment mm-hmm. and kind of just take them and store them. And so when you heat it, the moisture comes out on the pad, so you get a moist heat.
Oh, wow. This could be heated in the microwave?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then moist heat is better because it penetrates a little bit deeper than the dry heat does.
Or you can put it in the freezer?
Or you can put it in the freezer.
Wow, I didn't know there's one that could do both.
Yeah. We have
several that
can do both. And you just, it's Velcro. So as big or small as you want it. This is a great one for around your eyes, like for a headache, or around like a small joint, like an elbow or a knee.
That's a really good idea.
Yeah, I like that one.
Yeah, so does it stay, like if you take it from the freezer or the refrigerator, mm-hmm. would it stay cool?
It does. It stays cool. It's a better, actually, in all honesty, it's a better hot pack than cold pack.
Okay.
But it'll stay cold for about 20 minutes.
All right, very good. Great idea.
And then this is our professional. This is my favorite, and it is cold.
Wow.
This is my professional one.
Wow. That's
And it's gel.
Okay.
So it's a tiny bit heavier, but the benefit is sometimes the compression feels good.
Yeah.
But the neat thing about that's frozen pretty much. And it's been out of the freezer for probably about a half an hour.
Okay.
But it stays totally
flexible.
Well,
let's use this for its intended purpose, to keep my martini cold.
You know what? Priorities. Really.
Priorities.
Absolutely.
Another use. I have a question about this.
Uh-huh.
Is you put this in the freezer, mm-hmm. obviously, and it stays cold mm-hmm. for quite a while. And it's a gel in here. So it's mm-hmm. similar to... I know you sold the little gel packs mm-hmm. or something, but this mm-hmm. is obviously much heavier duty.
Yes,
than
it's
that.
More of a professional grade. The thing about this one is that because it does get so cold, you have to cover it. You can't put it directly on your skin.
Right.
So I usually say slip it inside a pillowcase, and then you
Good
can
idea.
You know put it wherever, and then only 20 minutes at a time.
Okay.
Because it starts to freeze the tissues, and that's not a good idea.
Okay. Now, the age-old question, mm-hmm. and because you are an occupational therapist.
Hot or cold. Okay, so it used to be cold, and it used to be the adage ice.
Mm-hmm.
So it's ice, compression, elevation.
Okay.
And that used to be the norm when you get an injury. And it used to be for the first 24 hours you would use cold,
mm-hmm.
next 24 hours you would use heat, and then after that you would use whatever feels good. The current thinking is that heat, as long as you don't have a lot of inflammation, because heat will increase inflammation, but as long as you don't have a lot of inflammation, heat is actually better on an injury. Because what it does, it increases the circulation.
Okay.
And then, as we all know, our blood has all these good little cleaner outers and nutrients, and the blood is good for, you know, eating away what hurts. So that's the
current. So maybe if you twisted an ankle, not major, but mm-hmm. cold, but maybe if you strain something in your back, working in the garden, heat, something like that?
Okay. And if it feels better after the heat, then, you know, stick with that. Sometimes you'll notice that it doesn't, and then go to the cold.
All right. Very good.
So then we have our newest, latest, greatest, of course.
Yes.
And that's our CBD. And our CBD comes in a multitude of varieties. I just brought a couple. But this is our tincture. Mm-hmm. And the difference is we have internal and we have external.
Right.
So the internal, the tincture is, this is a 3,000 milligram. So this is pretty much the strongest tincture that we have. There's actually a 3,000 plus that they're making now. But this is systemic. So it really works really well for like anxiety, depression, sleep, things like that. It's kind of a systemic thing. And it doesn't have any THC, so you won't get high.
Right.
You can travel with it. It doesn't show up in a blood test. People, pilots, they actually formulated for this, like people, like doctors, pilots, people that cannot test positive for any THC. So the tincture is there, and then it's a dropper full, however you want. If your doggies are anxious or...
I've seen this, and I think this is actually a good idea because you're trying to, maybe you're calming your dog down for some whatever reason.
Yeah.
And this is also, so this isn't pills, this is...
That is the tincture still for the dogs, and you can put it in your food.
So it's really the same as this, because I'm looking at the milligrams. Mm-hmm. Okay.
No, it's not. This is 300. Not. That's 3,000.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's right. Oh, I'm looking at the size of the bottle.
Yeah. Oh, the size of the bottle is the same. Yeah. And the dropper's the same. And
this one's beef flavored.
Yeah. Our 150 is chicken flavored.
Yeah.
So they love it. But I put a few drops on my fingers and my dog will lick it off my fingers.
Yeah.
And I do it when he gets really anxious. And like 4th of July.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Fireworks and all that.
And these don't, this doesn't like go bad. In other words, if I bought it and you use this maybe a few times a year, it's going to last.
It's going to last.
Good idea.
Yeah, it's an MCT oil, so it's going to last. And then we have different formulas. This one is a good morning formula. It has B vitamins in it, and it's a 50 milligram tab. With B vitamins.
Okay.
And so it's going to give you kind of some energy and, you know, focus throughout the day, which is really neat. This is my favorite. This is a melatonin. So this is for sleep.
Okay.
And it's again, a capsule with a melatonin, and it has 10 milligrams of melatonin.
Okay.
And so the only thing that I would caution people is that if you're sensitive to melatonin, take half a tablet.
Okay.
Or start with even a quarter tablet, because that would be like 2 milligrams of the melatonin.
And these are supposed to be all non-addictive, right?
Non-addictive, right.
Okay.
This one's for sleep, and it does work.
Now,
really
as far
well.
As, these are all over the counter, so obviously there's no, you don't need a prescription or anything like that.
Right.
Okay.
And then the other thing that we have in the store that I didn't bring that people love, and I've got two versions, well, I've got three. One is they're a pain cream. And the best one is the roll-on. It's a 250 milligram. And it acts like the 750 milligram because it's a roll-on, so you can kind of get into the tissues a little bit more rather than the topical cream that can rub off. So it's a roll-on, and that's a really nice one, too, for joint pain, muscle aches, those types of things.
Okay. Now, as far as getting these and figuring out which is right, in some cases... not the pet one, of course, but two or three of these may do the same thing. It's what you prefer.
Exactly.
Like if you want the roll-on for something topical, a certain area, whatever it might be.
Right.
Okay.
Right. And it kind of depends on your tolerance as far as, because these come in different milligrams.
They do.
So this is the highest at 3,000. We have 500 and 1,000 as well. So.
All right. Very good. All things to help mask your pain.
Yeah.
But as an occupational therapist, you're probably the first to say that your pain is telling you something. So
don't
ignore it.
Exactly.
Right.
And it's, yes, and that's really important. A lot of people think, you know, oh, I'm just being a wimp, especially people that tend to be really active and independent. You think, oh, I'm such a wimp for this hurting. But it's not true because it's there for a reason.
Right. All right.
Definitely.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Cheers.
All right. We'll see you next time. And if you ever need any help with something, Adapt to It is located right at El Toro Road and Paseo de Valencia. She's got a great staff there, Leslie does, and really good people. They'll help you out.
Thank you.
All right. We'll be right back. Good to see you. Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween.